Excess biotin in the blood from multivitamins, supplements, or even therapeutic doses can cause interference with some laboratory test results, causing false increases or false decreases, which can result in a patient being misdiagnosed or treated for the wrong disorder. I myself saw a case where this occurred. This involved a female patient who came to the Mayo Clinic to meet with her endocrinologist for the treatment and management of her hyperthyroidism, a condition in which the thyroid gland produces too much thyroid hormone. Her symptoms included heat intolerance, tremors, and changes in weight. And so her endocrinologist ordered several laboratory tests. And when these results came back, they showed a clear pattern of hyperthyroidism and Graves' disease, which is an immune system disorder that can cause hyperthyroidism. Her endocrinologist was treating her with a drug that's commonly used for hyperthyroidism, but her laboratory results indicated that she was not responding appropriately to the drug. Since she was not responding to this drug, her clinical team discussed the possibility of radioactive iodine ablation therapy. In this form of therapy, radioactive iodine is used to shrink the thyroid gland, ultimately destroying it. And while this is typically a very safe procedure, it can result in a couple complications, particularly the formation of hypothyroidism. And in this case, this is where the thyroid gland underproduces certain thyroid hormones. And as a result, it would require lifelong thyroid hormone replacement. In the meantime, the abnormal thyroid function results triggered a retesting protocol at Mayo Clinic that we implemented because of the fact that biotin can interfere with some laboratory tests. And when these samples were tested on an alternate testing platform, we found that the results were completely normal. In this case, biotin was causing the interference. In fact, her thyroid function was completely normal. Fortunately, the laboratory director on call at the time was able to immediately contact the patient's endocrinologist, inform him of the erroneous results, and then spare this patient a costly and unnecessary treatment and procedure that could have required lifelong therapeutic treatment. Biotin is a water-soluble ingredient that's commonly found in many multivitamins and over-the-counter supplements. There's no danger in taking biotin. In fact, you should not be afraid to do so. One important way to protect yourself from biotin interference is to know exactly the components of all the supplements and multivitamins that you're taking. And it's not always obvious. In the case of hair, skin, and nail supplements, biotin is usually a main ingredient, but it is not shown on the front of the label. In fact, you can only find that information on the back of the label, usually in small print. But patients should be aware that they should not take any biotin-containing supplements prior to a scheduled blood draw, as this can interfere with some laboratory tests. However, if you do take biotin on the day of your scheduled blood draw, it's important to alert your physician so that you can be retested at a later time. Be sure to read all of the labels on the multivitamins and supplements that you take, even if these are prescribed or over the counter. And if you're not sure that they contain biotin, consult with your pharmacist or healthcare provider. And it's very important that you always tell your doctor whether or not you're taking a multivitamin, supplement, or any other medications. These small steps can have a very positive impact on your diagnosis and treatment. I'm Dr. Brooke Katzman, co-director of the Hospital Clinical Lab and Point of Care Testing at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota.